Just ahead on CTV News, holiday travel is in full swing.
I'm Byron Scott. And while you can't tell, I'm on the move for the holidays.
Plus, we're in the kitchen cooking for the holidays and an in-depth look at how tree loss is affecting county residents. That and more up next.
Good evening, I'm Patricia Vallone with a CTV News update. Well, the big holiday rush is on with people heading out of town for Thanksgiving. Our Byron Scott is at a rest area with travelers.
The highways are busy and so too are the highway rest areas like this one on I-95 in Laurel.
What's the drive been like?
Good so far until here with the traffic. We have had no traffic so far.
Just take a look. All around are license plates from near and far. There are plates from Massachusetts, Florida, Connecticut, New Mexico, Virginia, Georgia, and Delaware, which brings us to
Amanda.
Amanda Fiore traveled all the way from California in her RV and moved to Delaware, all the way enjoying the sights.
I do get to see the whole country and also lots of animals. It's been fun with the animals, like deer and bear and moose and all of that.
I left yesterday afternoon about 1 o'clock.
Donald Rooney is heading to New England from Altoona, Florida.
Which is central Florida. And the holiday brings out the best in people. I haven't met a bad person on the trip up.
Motorists looking for a measure of relief today were greeted by this sign as they entered the Laurel rest area.
But when the holidays are here, you got to do what you got to do. Wherever you got to do it.
Good. Better than nothing, yeah, because there's traffic right now, so we figured why not stop now.
AAA Mid-Atlantic says more than 1.3 million people in the DMV are in the process of heading out of town.
And with the travel volume, traffic in general, particularly Wednesday afternoon when commuters are leaving work and we're seeing travelers trying to get out of town, that will certainly be a busy time as well.
We got on the road a little before 8 o'clock. The fog was pretty heavy starting off, but it cleared up. Now we're just now starting to hit traffic just south of Baltimore.
AAA and MDOT are among those stressing safe driving. Among the common sense advice, drive sober, slow down, pay attention, be patient, share the road, move over, and lastly, enjoy the holiday.
So what are you guys going to be doing?
Spending it with my family, who we get to see a few times a year, so excited to be up there.
Byron Scott, CTV News.
Well, the Prince George's Council votes against stricter cannabis dispensary regulations, making it possible for cannabis owners to set up shop near schools and in shopping centers. The council spent several months debating the possible new regulations before ultimately voting against them on Tuesday. Dispensary owners in the county are celebrating. Some say the state of Maryland already holds dispensaries to a higher standard of security and public safety than other smoke shops. Well, heated discussions about the Israel-Hamas war have spilled over to Maryland politics. Attorney General Anthony Brown has suspended Dr. Zainab Chaudhry from the Maryland Commission on Hate Crimes Response and Prevention. Chaudhry is the executive director of the Council on American Islamic Relations, or CARE. Brown says after learning last week about her social media posts since October 7th, he felt they risk disrupting the work and mission of the new commission. Now, meantime, Chaudhry and supporters have launched an online petition to reinstate the Muslim leader and civil rights activist. And you're watching CTV News. I'm Patricia Vallone. After the break, Taylor Thomas is in the kitchen cooking up a Thanksgiving dish. We'll be back in just a moment.
It's all about the collard greens. If you are like me and you do not know how to cook this delicious vegetable, stay tuned. We have a very special chef here. We'll tell you how simple it could be this holiday season.
Substance use disorder and addiction is so isolating. And so, as a Black woman in recovery, hope must be loud. It grows louder when you ask for help and you're vulnerable. it is the thread that lets you know that no matter what happens, you will be okay.
Welcome back. Well, it is the start of the holiday season where the turkey always takes center stage. Taylor Thomas is in the CTV kitchen showing us how to cook up a popular side dish.
Hi, I'm Taylor Thomas, and yes, we are in the midst of the holiday season. I brought in a very special chef to prepare one of the staple dishes for many for Thanksgiving. That's collard greens. Chef Adrian Stewart is joining us today. We're making collard greens, so what are you doing now?
So now I'm just adding in a little bit of our smoked turkey with our onions, and I'm going to have you add our collard greens in.
Okay. So how long do you normally cook this?
We cook it for about 45 minutes or until our collard greens are tender.
Now, you have ties to Prince George's County. You actually are an instructor at Crossland High School. Tell us about that.
Yes, I am a culinary instructor there with our CTE program. It's amazing. I love my students, and I've been there for about 3 years.
That is really, really interesting, and I love seeing young people getting into this industry. So you have, your family's been doing this for a number of years now, right?
Yes, yes. That's who I learned it from.
Okay, and now what are you putting in?
Right now I'm adding a little bit of Cajun seasoning just to give it a little bit of heat and flavor.
Okay, great. Anything that we should do in prepping the collard greens?
You want to make sure you clean them well, wash them about 3 or 4 times, and then chop them up so they don't take as long to cook.
All right, now you also are connected to Prince George's Culinary Arts School.
Yes, I am a chef instructor there. I teach food production and culinary basics.
All right, now what did you just put in just now?
That was a little bit of onion powder. I'm sorry, that was garlic powder, and we also have fresh garlic inside.
I love that. Now, we have to pull this all back into it, right? So you actually learned your culinary skills from New York.
Yes, I graduated from the Culinary Institute of America in New York.
Okay, and so this looks amazing. So this cooks for about 45 minutes. This is the finished product, right? Can I sample this?
Yes, let's get it plated.
Okay.
Going to add a little bit to your bowl, and you stick a fork in and see
this,
how it is.
Is this vinegar-based?
It is vinegar-based, and that smoked turkey is just beautiful in there, I believe.
This is delicious. You can find the recipe from our wonderful Chef Adrian Stewart on all of our social media accounts.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And Taylor will be back weekly with great side ideas and recipes for the month of December. And now coming up, Simon Bugs has our Wednesday sports page. Stay tuned.
I wonder if you know that I want the best for you. But how long will you fight solo? I wonder if you know that we can get help. Not wondering anymore. Love. Your mind.
Tree cover offers both heat and climate protection by having a cooling effect on the environment. But what happens when that tree canopy starts to disappear in our rapidly developing society? A new report says it's likely that it affects some communities much more than others.
We can see air temperatures which are up to 10 degrees higher than surrounding areas that have higher tree canopy. That creates this phenomenon known as urban heat island effects.
When tree canopies are replaced with impervious surfaces such as parking lots, something known as the heat island effect can take place. The term is given to urban areas where people suffer from higher energy costs as well as negative physical and mental health outcomes due to higher temperatures.
Without tree canopy and the loss of tree canopy in areas like urban and suburban areas, we actually see poorer quality of life conditions, which is a really, really large concern in terms of equity.
Dr. Robert Bullard has written numerous books on environmental and climate justice. He says it's quite common to cite development in lower income and minority communities and that tree loss can lead to environmental health threats.
And we know trees and other kinds of infrastructure will make for at least 10 to 12 degrees cooler. And if you look at those hot spots that were redlined in the 30s and 20s and look at which areas have more trees, which areas have more parks, walk trails, bicycle lanes, those amenities, And those amenities increase property values, and they also make people healthy.
Bullard says the loss of tree cover can directly affect a community's health. He cites how COVID-19 hit African American communities much harder than the general population.
And you can overlay race and other demographics with those urban heat islands and with where COVID is going and with those health disparities, those underlying conditions.
According to a recent report called Chesapeake Bay Tree Cover Status and Change, during a recent five-year period, Maryland lost 25,000 acres of tree canopies. Well, the biggest loss was right here in Prince George's County, 5,000 acres or 20% of the entire state. And it wasn't confined to just one area of Prince George's. It was spread across the entirety of the county.
The CBF says it's hoping Maryland and neighboring states will take a hard look at conserving existing high-quality forests and ramp up efforts where forests have been lost.
At all levels of government, we recognize that replacing the mature trees with younger trees is not the same thing. It's one of the reasons why you look to replace them with more trees. At some level, it's the nature of what happens with development. But we need to make sure that our policies do everything that we can to maintain, to replace, to maintain, and to enhance the tree canopy.
And Shapiro says the advent of climate change is speeding up the need to protect forests.
Everything that we're seeing related to climate change has raised the consciousness of that in the community, even in the development community, and certainly amongst us as community leaders. So we want to make sure we're doing our part.
And if you'd like to learn more about how to expand your city's tree canopy cover, you can go to the website c40knowledgehub.org, or you can find out more about the report itself by going to chesapeakebay.net.
Hey everyone, it's time for your Wednesday sports page. We'll start with some high school football news. The Wise High School football team will be in action again on Friday night, going up against Eleanor Roosevelt. The Pumas have talent all over the field, especially on the defensive side of the ball, as they have shut out 7 out of the 11 teams they played this year. And head coach DeLon Paris says the team's offense played a key part in the defense's success.
In the past couple years, we've been able to match offensively and defensively together. This year, because we had so much change, you know, we had to focus more on our foundation and who we are and how we plan to be physical. And I think that's helped us, you know, running the ball, playing defense. It keeps the defense off the field, controlling the clock and things of that nature.
Kickoff is at 6:30. Meanwhile, the Terps football team will take the field on Saturday against the Rutgers.
On offense, they try to shrink the game. They don't, you know, run a bunch of plays. They're not a big tempo team. They want to run the football. They want to control the time of possession, and they're going to make you make the plays. They're not going to give you anything.
That game starts at 3:30.
And wrapping up sports, the Washington Commanders will take the field tomorrow against the Dallas Cowboys.
Did not show up to play last time we played on Thursday, so we got to show up. Show out, put our best foot forward, do what we're capable of doing, make sure we're not playing against ourselves, not hurting ourselves, not beating ourselves, and get a W in Dallas.
The two teams will take the field at 4:30. And that is your Wednesday sports page. Simon Bugs, CTV Sports.
And that wraps up our CTV News update. Join us again on Monday and have a great Thanksgiving.
Hip-hop is an art form.
But it's more than that.
It's the consciousness
of people. And with that
comes responsibility.
Today,
all across the country,
hospitals and insurers
hide their prices.
And it's creating fear,
debt,
and devastation all over this country.
We need actual prices in healthcare.
Not averages.
Not estimates.
We need real prices.
We ask
our elected officials
to do better.
We demand prices
and transparency in healthcare.
Power to the patients.